When someone has died, they are so suddenly and completely gone, while everything that they have left behind is so pressingly and overwhelmingly there. What can be sadder, stranger, or more poignant than the rooms in which someone has lived? What can be harder, more arrogant, or more necessary than to clean those rooms out to make way for other lives? You have to say to the memories, you cannot take up this much space. You are no longer entitled to take up so much space. You're going to live with the grief that takes up so much space. And everything that we deem irrelevant will be discarded. And everything that we deem valuable will be divided amongst us. And your presence will be swept from these rooms. It will stand empty and bare. And some other person who is, after all, only temporarily alive will come and fill them with their own treasures and their own trifles. People like to have things to remember each other by. Looking at these sad, sweet, cluttered, empty rooms, I wish to leave nothing behind me when I die. So that secrets big and small may not fall into the hands of those who would not, could not, ever interpret them right. And for the first time I understand the privacy of the dead. Why it is in old age that we destroy what might be seen as precious mementos. Burning letters, tearing up poems, throwing out journals, discarding photos. It's because we become aware. The people related or unrelated, who bear us love or indifference or even hatred, will come to own everything that we own. There's not the slightest chance that they will discover the truth, because their truth is rendered in younger colours. So do we fear revelation more or misinterpretation more? As survivors, we regret how little we know, how little we find, how little we leave behind. How little we leave behind. How little we leave behind. Farewell, Margaret. Godspeed. Yeah, whatever that means. Farewell, Margaret. Godspeed. A turn of the century child became a millennial grandmother, almost a great grandmother. How did this happen? She might have cried. Time flies as we get older. A day is an eternity to a toddler. But in old age, it all slows down again. Too long, these last few painful years, each one so much the harder. The isolation of her failing ears, a frustration of a world growing smaller. And how hard to go from strength and capability to that. So small and frail in her small flat, like a withered leaf pressed between the pages of a book, waiting patiently for company, unable even to make them a cup of tea. But once she had laughed, danced, cooked meals, born children, suffered, loved, fought. Farewell, Margaret. Godspeed. Yeah, whatever that means. Farewell, Margaret. Never live to be 98, she told me when I first met her. It's not worth it. Never was. Old age is such a fetter. How are you, Granny? We lean and shout a whole long, slow year later. Getting a little old now, dear, she said, with her characteristic humour. I didn't get to hear your thoughts on turning 100 because you could no longer speak. But I think I know what you would have said to me. 100 years, you would have said. I must be a lunatic. And shaking your head.
Farewell, Margaret. Thank you.